ASMR politics. Seems appropriate. We are a week and a half out from the American general election day. So I thought I would give my thoughts on the current race between Donald Trump and Kamala Harris. Firstly, I would like to make a prediction. Is that Donald Trump will win. Whether or not you want that to be the case, that seems to be the most likely scenario currently. And I'll go into a couple reasons why. Firstly, my evidence every poll for the Electoral College, which is how you win the presidency in the United States. So that's what matters. National polls, a popular poll of, you know, hey, who's going to vote? Who are you going to vote for? Meaningless. What matters is a state-by-state poll, and in every swing state, I think in almost every swing state, Donald Trump is up. The betting markets are very clear on this. The last that I looked, Donald Trump looks to be ready to capture 312 Electoral College seats, far above the 270 needed to win the White House. Because of that, the betting markets have him sitting at a massively comfortable lead, something like 20 points ahead, 60% Trump, 40% Harris, which is a massive lead, massive. I think the betting odds are actually probably about correct. States is even just assuming that those polls are correct, he's set to capture, you know, enough seats to win the presidency. Historically, both in 2016 and 2017, Trump underperformed in the polls. Election day, when all the votes were counted, he performed much better than the polls would have indicated. He was never up in the 2016 election, and he won it. He was never up in the 2020 election, and he narrowly lost. It was very, very, very close in all of the swing states, very slim margins. So with him being up in the polls now, even if the pollsters have attempted to fix their methodology, he's likely still being undersampled. So if a poll says that in Pennsylvania, Trump is up by, you know, 1 point, 2 points, he's probably up more like 3 or 4 points. I mean, potentially up to like 7 points, but going with the conservative number, let's say, you know, he's up by probably an extra 1 to 2 to 3 points. Does that mean it's going to be a landslide victory for Trump? I don't know. That's something we really can't tell 100%. seats. It kind of depends on how he does it, which swing states he gets. But I would imagine that would be a pretty, you know, decisive victory. So that's my evidence. Why do I think people are voting for Trump? Why do I think he's up in the polls? There's a couple of reasons for this. Firstly, it has to do with just a general sense of how do people in America feel on a day-to-day basis. Feel like the last 4 years were good or bad? What has been your felt reality, your felt experience? Has it been good or has it been bad? Comparisons to the past, you can do those, but generally speaking, basically, if things suck now, I want to change. If things don't suck now, I'll stick around. I'll stick with what we got. This is the basis for one of the polls that, or one of the predictors, I should say, that keeps showing up in my news feed. Essentially, the basis for that prediction is simply, are things in the country going well? Do they feel like they're going well? Or do they feel like they're going bad? If a D is in the office and things are going bad, a lot of people are going to vote R. If an R is in office and things are going well, people are going to vote for an R. Democrat, Republican. It really just comes down to, are things currently going good and we want to stick with our team? We want to stick with the people that are doing well? Or, things are going poorly? And we want to make a change. Things seem, they feel like they're going poorly. So, a lot of people that would otherwise care about politics, they're going to vote for somebody else. They're going to vote for a change. Democrats are in power now, so a lot of people are going to vote for the Republican. Doesn't really matter who the candidate is. Also a divergence between the candidates. Trump is doing a lot of media and
mean, it seems to be doing very well. You know, like, he's on every cool podcast. He's being interviewed, like, nonstop by everybody. He's doing, you know, his late-stage media blitz. It's almost certain he's going to be on Joe Rogan's podcast. And that media exposure helps him. Much, and the stuff that she is doing doesn't seem to be landing. Does not seem to be landing. Doesn't seem to be translating into boosts in her numbers. Is anything there going down because of it?
Actually going to
is it just going to be like not voting? Which is, again, represented in the sort of the so-called enthusiasm gap. Which is, again, why Trump is up in the betting markets by such a large margin. I mean, 20 points. 20 points is, I mean, almost an insurmountable lead. All of the attacks against him, none of them have really landed. They're all old hat at this point. So you're not making any conversions over to your side. Whereas he's probably is making conversions over to his side. All of this together, it just reads like it's going to be a Trump victory. I mean, almost certainly. There was a moment about 2 months ago where the odds shifted. Trump was sitting, you know, in a comfortable lead against Biden for a good long while after the debate, especially. After the debate, especially. Once they switched in Kamala, it did switch a little bit. I think at one point she was actually running at something like 60 points ahead, but that very quickly shifted. And in all of that time, even when she was running significantly ahead in the, you know, betting odds, Trump was actually still forecasted to win in the Electoral College. It's not to say that something couldn't happen, but at this point it seems like if something were to happen, you know, in October, surprise, October's almost over. October's almost over. So even if there was something that were to come out, the people that aren't involved in politics don't follow news on a day-to-day basis, because why would you? So to convert some big, giant, surprise news story into switching votes, it takes time. And, you know, a week and a half, 10 days, whatever it is probably not enough time to actually release a story, have that story be disseminated, have it be talked about by enough people that people that don't follow politics hear about it through, you know, the grapevine, hear about it through word of mouth. So it doesn't seem like, you know, they can pull anything out at this point. It's not to say that it couldn't happen, it's just the odds are moving more and more towards a Trump victory. Which is, as I said, what I am predicting. So, I understand this is a little bit different of a video than normal, as I don't think politics are massively relaxing, especially given the state of the world. I think people talking about world affairs is probably actually very stressful for a lot of people, but I do hope this is say good luck in all your endeavors. Thank you for tuning in. I appreciate your time and attention. I suppose I should ask, who do you think is going to win? Respond in the comments. Help me out on the algorithm. And with that, I shall say...